A very good morning to one and all. So children, today we will be doing the last video of the lesson science, that is the plants reproduction. Now children, from the starting we did, we'll just have a small recap, and then after the recap we will just have a small activity and the last part of the lesson, that is the last topic of the lesson. So in the last videos we saw the lesson, that is the plant reproduction. So the first part, that is the first video I did, was of plant reproduction, that is the plants reproduce from different parts of the plant. So one, I had showed you the seed germination, the plants, how plants reproduce from the seed, that is the seed germination I had showed you. So some of the plants reproduce from the roots, some by the ferns, and then some by the leaves also. So then I showed you a video of a potato, where the potato has an eye, and from the stems they grow, because potato is a stem. Again, the sugarcane is also a stem. So these, some of the plants grow from the stems, some of the grows from the pores, that is the fern one. I showed you the video with the ferns. The some of the plants grow from the pores. Then on the leaves, okay, there are leaves which grow from the plants grow from the leaves also. Then I showed you the dispersal of these seeds, how the seeds dispersal happens by the wind, by the water, then by the animals, and then by the explosion. So then in the day before yesterday's video, we saw the different stages of the agriculture, how the agriculture happens, isn't it? Now, there is a small activity you can do is at home, that is the dispersal of the seeds. You can just categorize the different types of seeds, like which seeds disperse by the wind, so which seeds disperse by the water, and which seeds disperse by the animals and the explosion also. So you can just categorize some of the seeds and make a chart on that. You can just categorize these all things. Next children, I showed you the different types of different stages of the agriculture, how the process of agriculture happens. Like first the ploughing happens, means the soil which is being soil is being loosened up, and then by the various equipments, and then sowing of the seed happens. Then afterwards adding the manure to the the seeds which have been sown, then the manure is being added, then the irrigation, that is the planting, water is being supplied, sufficient water is being supplied to the crops, then harvesting. Once the crop has been reaped, then ripe, then the harvesting is being done, and then whatever the harvest has happened, then it has been stored into a stored properly and prevented through, I mean, some damage should not happen, so it has been prevented. And then again, some of the seed, if there are like rice, if they want rice to grow, the same rice next year, so they will keep some of the seeds for themselves for the next year to sow the same seeds. So this was a small recap which we had done in the previous class. Now we will come to the last part of the lesson, that is protecting the crops, isn't it? Now we saw how the plants grow, then we saw the stages of the agriculture. Now we will see how to protect the crops. Protect the crops means crops can be, you must have seen often in the fields, you must have seen the scarecrow. Now what is the scarecrow? उसे हिंदी में बिजू का कहते हैं. तो मींस नाउ द स्केक्रो you know why this scarecrow is the name from the from that name only you can understand it is to scare the crows. Those should the bird should not come and eat the grains. So the scarecrow is being made so that the birds or birds might think that it is someone who is standing in the field and they won't harm the crops. The farmers often built some of the farmers often built the fence, you know, wo jo, like it is of wires, okay, the iron wires to protect the crops from the gazing animals like cow, goat. So they come and gaze. As they are gazing, they should not enter the crops. So the fence is being covered throughout the whole crop. So with the wire friends, then the birds also destroy the crops. So there is they made this scarecrow have to keep away the birds. Then some of the you must have seen the small insects on the plants. For that they use some fertilizer. They use the chemical fertilizer so that those all insects shouldn't eat or shouldn't harm the crops. So they do that, and then once the crop has been harvested, a farmer needs to protect the crops from small animals and moisture. So harvested grains and pulses are stored in the airtight container. So pesticides and are also used to protect the grains and pulses. Healthy seeds are stored by the farmer for the next year's crops. Now you must have seen, if you want to store, you must have seen your mother also storing these some grains of the whole year which she brings from the market. How she stores? She what she does is, she'll take the grain, she'll put it into the hot sun, okay, and once it has been means the grains has been hot, after getting them down, what you can put some neem leaves or the boric powder what you get in the market to that, apply that. Otherwise, the best thing is to put the neem leaves into the grains and then you can store it for long time. So this is the process how it happens, and you can protect your crops not to get harmed or damaged from the insects or any in the small animals. Now children, as we saw that I told you in the last video also that you should plant more and more trees, isn't it? I told you to plant more and more trees, isn't it? So by that, even in the same hand in hand, even if we are planting the new trees also, the birds, okay, some of the birds that like sparrow, because of our food radiation, they are getting destroyed, and even they are not getting ample amount of food and even the water also. So today we are going to see a beautiful activity. See, now at home, so we don't have any crops, okay, so we can't make any scarecrow to scare the birds. But instead of making a scarecrow, we can make a beautiful birds feeder. Nowadays you must have seen it is very hot, these are the summer days, so the birds are not getting enough of food or not even the water. So what you can do is you can make a small homemade waste material we can make a birds feeder. So I will just show you a small activity how can we make. So for that you need a plastic bottle, any bottle you can take, or the spoons, you can even use these plastic spoons also. And children, be very careful when you are using this cutter, okay, but see that you can even use the scissors also, but here I am using a cutter. Whenever you are doing this activity, see that you are doing it in front of the observation of your any adult, means any elderly person, whether your mother or your father or even your grandparents, okay. Please do not do this activity on your own, okay. So please take the help to cut the bottle of your elder people. Otherwise, this is one of the activity which I am showing. There are n number of things which you can do. There are n number of different activities, means different ways to make the birds fitter. But see that you please use the waste things which are available at your home. So this activity will be the best out of waste. Okay, so birds feeder, making the birds feeder, the reason is because at summer what you should do is you take the small this like this kind of bottle, and then you need to cut over here. You just have a small cut over here so that the spoon, okay, so just see that you just put your spoon like this and see the other end. So I need to make a cut over here. So make a small cut. Okay. See. Now don't cut full. See. Can you see this? So just my spoon will go. So this. This should be open. Okay. So like this. Then what you can do is this cap. Make a hole, a small hole into this cap. Okay. Now actually these type of bottles cut very fast, because then you can take a jute, any string, okay, any string, and just put the string into this. The hole which you have made, just put that string into that. Yeah. Okay. And after putting the string into that hole, what you need to do is you need to make a small knot, because the string shouldn't come out. Okay. So here, see this. Okay, like this. After that, what you can do is here you can pour the grains into the bottle. You can take a small bottle for children. Okay, so if you take the small bottle, what will happen? The amount of grains, okay, what you have put. So, otherwise we need to make another cut. Okay, we'll cut it from this side. See, what will happen, you know, if you cut it like this, the grains, this, and the bird will come and have the grains from here. And then what you can do is, if you take a small bottle, what will happen, the amount of grain fit into that will be little. So as it finish, so you can just put it like this on any of your tree, and even the water also you can do in the same type. You can just make the bottle upside down. And like this way, you can make a bird's feeder at home. There are many different things also. So please see that. Or if not this, you can do even one more thing. You can just take some two bowls, and in one bowl you can put some grains, and in another bowl you can put some water, and keep it on the top of your house, where in your terrace or somewhere where the birds come. So this also can help for the birds. So please see that you do this activity at home. Thank you and have a nice day.